party cooperation is something that matters a lot for China, I mean, for the Chinese Communist Party itself and for the Chinese government and the Chinese state. And they invest a lot of resources in international party cooperation. So they have a broad outreach to more than 400 parties across the world. And we see that since Xi Jinping has come to power, the CCP has invested a lot more resources in its international party contacts. And so it means something for them. And the size of the circles indicates how many parties the CCP has been meeting in that country between 2000 and 2017. So bigger circles mean that there are a lot more contacts, and we immediately see that there are more contacts in Asian countries. So for instance, in Japan, Vietnam, or Laos, we see that there have been a lot of contacts in Europe, specifically in Central and Eastern European countries, but also in Germany. And we see that there are a number of circles in Africa, and particularly in South Africa, Sudan, Ethiopia, and other places. In the map, the number of pies in the circles indicates the number of parties that the CCP is meeting. This means that there is, in some countries, the CCP is only meeting one party, and very often this is the ruling party. This is the case very clearly in Vietnam or Laos, but this is also the case in a number of African countries where the CCP is only meeting with the main ruling party. And then we have some countries where we see that the CCP has a lot of partners, and then often from government and from opposition. For instance, in India or Japan or also in Germany, the CCP is meeting many different parties. And interestingly, we also see that the circle for the United States is very small. So we find very few contacts between the CCP and the Democrats and Republicans in the United States.
In addition to investigating this network of party-to-party contacts, we also investigated what the actual content is that is discussed in such a network. And what we found is that on the one hand, the network serves just as another channel to promote very, very commonly understood Chinese national foreign interests. And that can be fending off human rights criticism, but it can also be justification for the Chinese position in the South China Sea and confirmation for the One China policy. Another function of these party-to-party contacts is to generate legitimacy for the Chinese leadership towards a domestic audience, but also towards an international audience. Nowadays, of course, under Xi Jinping, that's the Chinese Dream and the Belt and Road Initiative, of course, that are frequently mentioned in these party-to-party contacts. And then there's a third function that we find really interesting, and that is that these party-to-party engagements can be used as a channel for organizational learning. And so we see that increasingly the Chinese Communist Party itself considers its external relations as a channel to promote the Chinese model of governance. Interestingly, the Chinese Communist Party is also increasingly committing to supporting others in organizational learning, in setting up party schools and supporting anti-corruption campaigns and, you know, transmitting their knowledge of governance.